just can't wait to tell you that I love you. Time keeps passing by. You're not here. I feel so alone when I don't have you near. What's up, my furry little friends? Anyway, we're gonna go ahead and start creating the shape that we need to place our rhinestones with the glue gun. And I actually left this part in, that way you guys can see. Do not be like me and touch this darn glue, cause it's hot. Anyway, I peeled it off. The reason why I did that is cause it's gonna leave a little bit of a mark for me to trace, and I'm gonna go back in with the glue gun and stick on these little rhinestones. I got these rhinestones over at Michael's for like 10 bucks. And it gives you a bunch of different sizes. I believe they give you like 550. So it was necessary for this project. You're gonna just continue to trace along that. And the only reason why, of course, I didn't use the original mark by going all the way around and you have to keep going is because the glue dries really fast. So you wanna make sure you work really fast, because of course, anyway, that's what it's gonna look like. And you wanna just go ahead and repeat the same exact step as I'm gonna do here. And of course, use a bra that you know you're never gonna use again, because you're just never gonna use it again. I mean, hello, duh. All right, so this is what it's gonna look like. Now we're gonna go ahead and start with the red. With the red, I actually wasn't able to use rhinestones. I think I had to use it was sequins. There you go. And they didn't have like packets of it, so I had to buy like little Christmas packets that had the red sequins in it. And I believe they were like $3 a pack, and it lasted me the entire look for both the bustier and the pants. And just so you guys know, this look did take me about 4 hours to do. Maybe it would have taken me less if I didn't take breaks, but whatever. It took me about 4 hours. I personally didn't mind doing it because I love projects like this, but if you are someone that doesn't have a lot of patience, I don't really know how you're gonna really do this project here. Alright, so as you see, I'm gonna go ahead and just close this up. I wanted you guys to see what it looks like when you're finishing. It's like, you know what it is? It's kind of like a puzzle too when you're like almost finished and you're like, yes, I'm gonna be done. And yeah, this is a finished boosty caca and some ignorance.
I'm filming.
Really, dude. Anyway, now we're gonna go ahead and get onto our pants. Now, I chose to not do regular black leggings. I wanted to do my leather ones because I wanted to be a little fancy with it, okay? Anyway, I'm gonna not go over the zipper, duh. But what I did notice when gluing the stones onto this, it did tighten up my pants a bit, so it made it a little harder for me to put them on. So I would just say make sure they're really stretchy. And just, I guess, keep stretching them out as you go, just so you can see how they're doing. I don't know if that's good advice, guys. Listen, I'm new to YouTube, okay? I don't know the correct lingo. Just bear with me. But anyway, you guys can continue to look at a reference picture. That's what I was doing this entire time. I was looking at a reference picture and just going off of that. And it's pretty easy, as you guys can see. I'm pretty much just using my glue gun, using my glue sticks. I bought a pack of 18 glue sticks. Again, this entire project was actually pretty cheap. I already had these black pants at home, as well as a black bra that I didn't need. And I spent $27 altogether on just the little crystals here and the sequins, as well as the glue gun and the glue sticks. So, oh, and the fabric. So $27 for a costume is not bad at all. It's just time consuming, so you have to like really want to be into this. Alright, so now we're gonna actually start again with the red sequin. So, you know, just create your own little patterns, whatever's gonna keep you entertained. I kept switching up my patterns just to entertain me more so, because I was getting bored of, I mean, hello, look at all that space that I had to do there with the red sequin. You know, play whatever music you wanna play, some Selena, and you know, have some fun with this mine. All right, and this is the finished look for the pants, as you guys can see. Now we're gonna actually get started on the fabric. So you're gonna see that the fabric here is almost like a tablecloth fabric, instead of me using the leather fabric that she would actually use for the bra. But this is what I was able to get my hands on. So as you can see, I already had glued it on the inside of the bra, and my bra shape was different than hers. So it laid on top of me a little different. But anyway, if the straps itself is not long enough, go ahead and glue them together like you're gonna see me do here. And it's actually sturdy enough so you don't have to worry about it like ripping or stretching apart later on in the night. But definitely measure it to you. So I made it really long, then I went ahead and put everything on and pretty much measured out everything that was hanging off, and then I would cut it. I would still leave it a little long, you know, just in case. I mean, this is for my actual Halloween look, and I made it a month ahead, so I don't know how much weight I'm gonna gain. I mean, it's October, guys. I love my candy apples, I love my pumpkin pies, I like to get funky with the food, damn it. Anyway, as you can see, I'm going to just snip off any excess fabric that we have going on there. And with the glue gun, I'm just gonna, you know, continue to glue everything onto the bra straps that need to be... I don't know if I'm making sense. I hope you guys are more visual learners, because I feel like I'm not explaining this correctly, and that's why we have tutorials to show you. Sorry. Alrighty, my friends, this here is the finished look. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and I hope this was actually helpful. I hope you guys, you know, try this look out. So, enjoy your Halloween.
Hola, ¿qué tal, amigos? Yo soy Selena, y quiero invitarlos a para que vean el show de Padrísimo cada domingo. No se lo pierdan. That's, I said rock.
Era al show Padrísimo por su primer aniversario. Al show de Padrísimo por su... ¡Hola, amigos! Y quiero decirles...